Hey there folks, my name is Aaron and I'm an interpretive student aide with East Bay Regional Park District. Today, I'm alongside the stretch of Alameda Creek that runs through Sonola Regional Wilderness. The winter rains are beginning to make the creek behind me swollen and full of light. But if I were to go back to this very spot just over a couple hundred years ago, I might also be witnessing the beginning of one of the most spectacular wildlife events in all of the Bay Area. And that's the winter migration of the steelhead trout. Alameda Creek and its tributaries historically supported what were probably the largest migrations of steelhead trout in all of the Bay Area, as well as some impressive runs from Chinook salmon, coho salmon, Pacific lamprey, and a host of other cold water fishes returning from the ocean up the creek to breed. However, the past century and a half or so, dams and other water projects have made migration up the creek incredibly difficult. And for the last 50 years or so, access to the creek has been completely blocked. And as a result, many of these species have stopped returning altogether. However, a few determined steelhead still attempt to migrate up the creek each year. And as a result of the efforts from dedicated scientists, advocates, and activists, you may soon be able to see them migrating up the creek once again. So today, I want to talk about what makes steelhead, trout, and salmon so special, and how restoring and maintaining their populations can provide a blueprint for living sustainably in the Bay Area. Steelhead, salmon, and trout are all members of the same family known as the Salmonids. Salmonids are defining species of the West Coast waterways. They are central to the culture, spirituality, and livelihood of many indigenous communities. They are a food source for many throughout the Northern Hemisphere, and they're also beloved by anglers. What they're probably most famous for is their unique life journey that takes place in both freshwater and the ocean. Fishes with this type of life cycle are known as anadromous, and a great example of an anadromous fish is the steelhead trout, which is actually the name given to rainbow trout that have this type of life cycle. Otherwise, the two are exactly the same species. Historically, steelhead trout, Chinook salmon, coho salmon, all made anadromous journeys from the Pacific Ocean and San Francisco Bay to the upper reaches of Alameda Creek. Their populations were supported by unique aquatic habitats that dominated areas like Union City, the Sonola Valley, and the Tri-Valley. These areas that now hold cities and hundreds of thousands of people were densely packed with wetlands, ponds, and streams that flooded during the winter. But it was this network of unique aquatic habitats that allowed salmonid populations to move freely for dozens of miles throughout the East Bay. Salmonids have also in part shaped the ecosystems in the East Bay that have historically supported them. For instance, when they reach the end of their lives, they provide meals for tiny invertebrates that form the base of the entire food chain, as well as for wildlife species like turkey vultures and bald eagles. But on top of this, their carcasses release nutrients that were gathered from feeding at sea into areas further inland that would otherwise not have access to them. And it's these nutrients that have helped fuel the rich diversity of plant and animal life called the Bay Area home. So you might wonder, what changed? Why don't we see fish in droves this time of year? And to answer that, we have to look at the one thing that both humans and fish rely on: water. Since colonization by European settlers and the later urbanization of the Bay Area, Alameda Creek watershed has experienced enormous change. Dams, water diversion tunnels, and other water projects act as barriers to fish migration and degrade aquatic habitat. Over the past couple hundred years, dozens of these structures have been constructed along Alameda Creek and its surrounding tributaries. For example, in the first half of the 20th century, dams were constructed that now make up San Antonio, Calaveras, and Del Valle reservoirs. These structures completely blocked access to major portions of the upper part of the Alameda Creek watershed. More recently, in the early 1970s, a structure called a weir was constructed in the lower portions of Alameda Creek watershed to provide structural support for BART trains passing across Alameda Creek. As a result, species like coho salmon have stopped returning from Alameda Creek. Others, like steelhead trout, still attempt to migrate, but cannot make it past this weir. Steelhead trout are what is commonly referred to as an indicator species. This means that when their populations are healthy, there's a good chance the water they live in is healthy too, which means it's also healthy for other organisms, and of course, for us too. Alameda Creek and its surrounding lands provide excellent opportunities for hiking, biking, fishing, and wildlife viewing, things that have impacts on our health. So being able to maximize the health of the creek has benefits for human communities just as much as it does natural ones. Luckily, over the last 20 years, there's been a large collaborative effort between local organizations, including East Bay Regional Park District, to restore steelhead populations in Alameda Creek. Barriers to steelhead migration, like dams that no longer have any use, have been removed. And on top of this, each winter at the Bart Weir, a team of scientists and local volunteers will organize fish rescues in order to assist migrating steelhead beyond the weir. To do this, they'll use seine nets to capture steelhead below the weir, and then they are then equipped with radio tags so that scientists can track them. From there, they are transported upstream of the weir, where they can then search for suitable spawning habitat. And it's because of these efforts that in 2008, the first recorded spawning steelhead was found in Alameda Creek in over 50 years. And on top of this, due to the current construction of a fish ladder that will allow passage beyond the weir without the assistance of scientists, you may be able to see greater numbers of steelhead in Alameda Creek over the next few years. Steelhead trout in Alameda Creek are on track to become an extraordinary success story, but there is still work to be done. Steelhead and their salmonid relatives throughout the West Coast are threatened by climate change through things like drought and loss of cold water habitat. This means that more collaborative efforts to restore and maintain their populations will be needed. And the more we're able to promote intact and climate-resilient ecosystems, the better served both human and animal communities will be. Steelhead, salmon, and trout provide enormous benefits to both human and natural communities. But more than that, they're a perfect example of how protecting wildlife and their habitats can help us accomplish goals of sustainability. And as we continue to face challenges like climate change, the lessons that these animals provide will be increasingly important. So as you explore East Bay streams this winter, take a closer look at what's beneath the surface, because it may just offer a glimpse into our future here in the Bay Area. Thank you all for joining me today, and as always, enjoy your East Bay Regional Parks.